On this episode of This Old House, you can only guess what I've been watching this morning. I just felt like saying that. I'm kind of loopy anyway. Oh well. To the good stuff. Let's talk cowls for a little bit. Everybody knows them because they're on a majority of our airplanes, but everybody hates them. To putting them together, to painting them, to mounting them, to cutting them for your exhaust and your cylinder heads. Everybody hates cowls. I hate cowls. But without them, our planes just look ugly as snot. I mean, look. Steerman cowl right there. Steerman with no cowl. Looks ugly. So we gotta have it. We'll get to this one here in a minute. This is actually not mine. What is today? Sunday? So yesterday, I finally did the maiden on my buddy Cole's Top Flight P-47, and flew fantastic. Little trims, little things to do here and there, but upon landing, we had noticed that the cowl had come forward into the prop. And the reason that happened was the cowl mounts that attach to the cowl, they kind of come off the front of the airplane like this and attach to the cowl this way. And he followed the instructions, reinforced them, and glued and screwed them to the firewall. Everything that he did stayed in place on the airplane. But the glue joints that were done by the manufacturer are what broke. So, go figure. It's an ARF. But when it came forward into the cowl, or when the cowl came forward into the prop, you see this nice, pretty lip right here? Ooh, look at that. I am trying to recreate that now, because this came so far into the prop for probably the majority of the flight, but we had no idea that it was doing that. It had wore through the lip almost to the point where you could put your finger through it. So he was getting ready to buy a new cowl, and I said, well, you can if you want, but I know I can fix this cowl. He goes, it'd just be easier to order a new one. He goes online, looks it up. $80. I go, you sure you don't want me to fix it? So we took it off the plane, and I decided to take it home and fix it. And I just want to give you a couple little how-tos on several different cowls here, on repairs and just basic stuff on cowls, since we all have cowls, but most of us hate them. So to start off with the repairs, it might be kind of hard to see. I'm trying to get in the lighting just right. You can see where I've put in some heavy glass. I cut it into strips about yay wide and placed the glass to basically rebuild the inside of this lip, because this was worn almost all the way through. Now, before I laid that glass on there, on this side, I took some Scotch Blue painter's tape and basically in sections, because you can't take a 3-inch wide piece of painter's tape and wrap it around a corner. So in sections like that, I put it on and I wrapped it around, kind of so the tape itself was kind of recreating this nice smooth lip. Of course, it didn't do 100% perfect, but because that tape was there, kind of recreating the lip and also creating a barrier, when I put the resin and the glass inside, the epoxy that went through the glass basically went through the glass and then puddled onto the tape and settled and kind of recreated that little bit of a lip all the way around, which works out very well. So now this is brutally strong, very strong, and because I had the tape on there, a lot of the shaping that I'm basically now in the process of recreating with Bondo was done with epoxy. So you can see this turned out pretty well. This is just the first coat of the putty, and you can see I got a lot of sanding and a lot more filling to do. So I'm probably going to repeat this process another two or three times. And but already, I mean, it's for the first coat, that's not bad. That's not bad at all. And it looks worse than it is because I piled it on heavy. So even though this is still kind of pitted and kind of a crater, a lot of this is going to be sanded down anyway, So it's actually going to look a lot better for the first coat. But I'm still anticipating two or three processes of putting on the putty and sanding it. Then when it's done, I found some Rust-Oleum 2X that it may not be easy to see through the camera, but that's pretty darn close. That is really close. The gloss apple red, good stuff. And because this is a 2X paint, I don't have to prime that or anything. I can just do a couple mist coats to kind of act as my tack and primer coat and put a couple heavier coats on. We'll be good to go. And I'm going to repaint the whole band all the way around. So that'll work good for that. It's kind of a little, you know, how to repair and beautify a cowl. It's really not that hard. You do the same concept if you have any damage. Like, let's say, just for instance, you know, this hole here is cut out for the exhaust, for the exhaust stacks to come through like this. Let's say you decided to go with a different muffler, and the muffler was coming out the back. And now you got a big hole here. Well, the way to fix that would be, go to your local hobby shop, assuming you have one, and find some really thin ABS plastic. It's you can get them in sheets. They're mainly used for like model railroad because they're pliable. You can kind of bend them and they'll stay in their shape. And what you do is you take that piece of ABS plastic, and you can use fiberglass if you want and make your own piece. But you're gonna pre-mold it using heat and just pressure, and basically contour it to the inner shape of the cowl. Then you're gonna take that piece and glue it right in. Boop. You're gonna glue it in right over the hole, just like that. So then, once that dries, or once it's in there, you can lay some glass in here and kind of feather it out a little bit, and kind of build up, because you have something in here, but now you got a gap between the outer layer of the cowl and where that new piece is you put in. So you need to fill that in. You don't want to use 100% Bondo or putty, because that's going to crack. So fill it in with some glass cloth, make it as flush as you can, then come in with your putty and kind of and do an area, you know, about like this, just like if you're doing a drywall patch. Just because your patch is this big, you need to do your blending about out to here, so that way you get a good blend. Now, unfortunately, if you're doing something like that, this size on a cowl like this, you're probably going to be repainting the majority of the cowl, especially if we don't have a paint match, because you can't buy commercially the paint that Top Flight uses on their cowls. Because nope, it's not luster coat. But once you blend it all in, hit it with some primer, do some final sanding, and repaint the cowl. So instead of buying a cowl, you've now reinforced and filled in a hole. So just kind of a lot of people don't know that it's that easy. All right, on to this guy. So this is the cowl for my Big Balsa USA Steerman. Gotta hold the camera pretty far away to keep it in the screen. That's a big cowl. The reason it's off the airplane is I had to put in baffles to keep the engine cool. Now, the downside to a baffle like this is you have so much air hitting this that it's almost like taking the sanding block, holding it above it, and dropping it right through. I mean, that's the air hitting it is putting so much pressure on there. So when you look at this side, you know, ooh, pretty. It's all custom to fit around the engine. Now watch this. Ew. That's what they look like on the inside. Disgusting and very raw. But anyways, I kept having problems with the bottom part of the baffle pulling away from the cowl, coming loose and breaking inside the cowl. So what I did now is I made 5 of these little scabs right here. Glued them on just with CA. They're butted right up against the cowl. They're even sanded to match the contour of the cowl. And now that they're CA'd in place, I'm going to get some more epoxy. I'm just gonna goop all around them, goop them onto the actual baffle itself, and I'm just gonna goop it all on there. So now I've increased the amount of surface area that's being attached to the cowl by a great deal, because before it was just being glued on by just this little lip right here, and that's just not enough. This one seems to hold just fine because it's much smaller. It's under a lot less strain from the airflow hitting it. And then I'm going to mix up some resin, because inside here I can't quite fit my fingers in there, but I can get my fingers out of the way. There's a little bit of a lip behind the bottom part of that baffle. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to prop the cowl up, about something like that. Mix up some resin and just pour it down in here, because as long as the cowl is up on end like this, the resin, when I pour the resin in, it'll flow right down this way and it'll flow down this way, and it'll fill in that whole thing with resin, so that will never ever come loose again. And another thing, as you can see on this cowl, I had to cut a couple big holes for the exhaust to come through the bottom. And normally you wouldn't want to do that in this type of situation, because there's not a whole lot of meat left right here. So this is a point of failure. This is where the cowl is going to break. But as you can see, I'm putting a lot of pressure on it, and it's not breaking, it's not cracking, or nothing. Why is that? Once again, hard to see on camera, but from about here all the way over to here, you can kind of see it right there. I've re-glassed this whole part of the cowl with, I think, a 3 or 6 ounce cloth, really thick glass cloth, basically just so I can reinforce this area right here. So now it's super strong and super rigid. So just another thing to do if you have to cut a hole in your cowl for any size airplane. It can be from a 40 size airplane up to a giant scale like this. If you get to a point where you have very little meat left, you need to reinforce that inside, or else it's just gonna break over time. It's gonna crack, and as you can see, no cracks, nothing, absolutely perfect. So that'll do it for today's segment on Let's Talk Cowls. That sounded corny as hell. Oh well. Anywho, I'm going to take advantage of the wife not being here and do some more work around the house, and probably come down later and get these two cowls wrapped up, get that one put back on the steerman, and get that one prepped for paint. So, all right. Later.